It's more than a century old, but still one of the best around as you get a great look at Fenway Park here in Boston. We celebrate Jackie Robinson Day with a great matchup between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Boston Red Sox. It's Red Sox baseball, and it's coming up next. Drew Pomeranz, a southpaw from Tennessee, is the man on the mound. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. And we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Center fielder.
Underway at the ballpark this afternoon as the first pitch is in there for strike one. Well, these Red Sox entering play here this afternoon, HR. They come in unbeaten and playing well here in the early going.
They look like the best team in baseball right now. Every team sits out and says, can we win double digits in a row when you put your roster together? Can our rotation go through and win a couple games each? Well, that's what this club is doing right now. They're in double-digit territory of a win streak, and when you're doing that, you're doing everything right.
And here's the starting lineup for the visiting Tampa Bay Rays. Dan Plesac, who are you focused on?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited to watch Kevin Kiermaier.
In prior matchups against Drew Pomeranz, 4-for-15.
D-Rod.
And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
That's the perfect pitch after you've just brushed a guy back. The hitter probably isn't sitting up there thinking you're going to flip something soft up there.
Well, that was a pretty good swing right there. Tough changeup. Back-to-back changeups, he fouls it off. Now you get the pitch you want because I can't see him throwing another changeup right here.
There you see Evan Longoria waiting next. Betts will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
Batting third, third baseman Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman Evan Longoria. Comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game.
Yeah!
And he gets ahead 0-1.
Frozen with a high fastball there. We'll see if they try to climb the ladder even more on the next pitch.
Goodness. 0-2 now.
Well, that's not a good pitch for him to hit. Look, this fella's got so much power, but you gotta bring the pitch into the zone. Chasing that one there, right there, I'd go back and throw it to him again. I like the call for the two-strike changeup, but you gotta make a better pitch. He got away with one right there.
Now this is swung on, and here's another fly ball out to right field. In there, a base hit. And that means that Corey Dickerson will bat with two out.
Well, he got jammed on that one right there, and he's just strong enough to muscle it into right field for the base hit. It'll be a line drive tomorrow in the paper.
Into the box now, Corey Dickerson.
Yeehaw!
As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. 0-1 count, here's the pitch. Had him off balance a bit as this is skied into short left center. Benintendi is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. One left for Tampa. Tampa Bay nothing. Red Sox coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball, the show. Alex Cobb gets the ball for the Rays in this one. What do we need to know here, HR?
Well, Matt, if you look at the rotation, this is the guy everybody questions. How's he still in? ERA over 5 last season. But what I see is a guy that they trust.
Leading
he's
going
to take the ball. He's going to go be out there and battle. And let's just see if maybe he can turn this trend around of inconsistency.
Oh, here's a shot out to right center. And this will kick up against the wall near the Red Sox bullpen. And the Red Sox have something going. It's a leadoff double.
You could tell he was thinking fastball all the way here, and that's exactly what he got. He was able to get the bat hit out front and pull it into the gap in the right center. Now they're set up pretty nicely for a good inning after that leadoff double.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. Couple of hits for him in 4 trips to the plate last night. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And they've got him hung up out there between second and third. And they'll get the out here as he's run down between second and third.
Batting third.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. He comes into this April contest as one of the hottest hitters in the league. His season average up into the high 300s now. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. And Harold, the Rays, as they begin play here this afternoon. Despite the loss last time out, they'd won four in a row, so they've been on a nice little roll here.
Yeah, Matt, I mean, I'm impressed how they're playing on the road. They're 3-1 on this road trip, and they're putting it together. If they continue to keep it running like this, we're looking at a really good ball club.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes is Mr. Earl Hendricks.
Yeah, Matt, Hendricks is another one of those well-respected umpires. Some say he favors one side of the plate from time to time, but most of the time, it's not very noticeable.
Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. In there, no balls and a strike. The 0-1 on its way. Check swing grounder to the right side. Pedroia has it. Throw to first. He'll be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Batting six.
At the plate, Brad Miller. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. And this is swung on and hit on the ground at Pedroia at second. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. Eduardo Rodriguez comes in unexpectedly from the pen in relief of his injured teammate.
Eduardo Rodriguez.
Into the box now.
Batting seventh, right fielder, Steven Souza.
First offering on its way. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And some action now in the Boston bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing.
D-Rod.
Swing and a miss for strike one. Got a big pass at a slider that gets past him. No score here as we play inning number two. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Down in order go the Rays. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Here's Mookie Betts. Lifetime history with Alex Cobb, one for six.
Mookie Betts.
This one's down to third. And this ball gets right past him. Boy, looked like he was in position, but they'll have a leadoff base runner.
That's the seventh game he's hit in. Look out, seven games. That's 1 week of feeling pretty good. Let's see how long he can make this last.
Hit well towards the hole. And Ramirez is aboard, hits a base hit.
Back-to-back hits, and now the inning is set up. They're trying to put the first run on the board, so you can bunt, move them up. Now you're second and third. You may draw the infield in. Or if they sit back, get the easy ground ball, and you pick up the first run of the game. But it's all set up with those back-to-back singles, and now you can do whatever you want to do with the rest of the inning.
Here's Jackie Bradley now as he lines it hard to the right side but out of play. Oh and one, here it comes. Here's a swing and a high pop up drifting toward the third base dugout, and this will be taken in by Longoria for the first out.
All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the Rays.
Batting seven.
And behind the plate first is Wilson Ramos. Great hands, quick feet. He's really become one of the best catchers in the league right now, defensively, that is.
And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
Matt, it looks like he was sitting there getting ready to jump on the first pitch fastball, and they pulled the string on him and threw him a changeup and just got him out front. Now I don't know what he's thinking up there at the plate or what he might be looking
for. Just a sec now as that ball finds its way into the outfield, a base hit. And the run will score as the Sox are off to a 1-0 lead.
Well, no surprise to get an RBI single early in the game. They are hot. This team is on a winning streak. I'm telling you right now, I don't know who's going to slow them down because, once again, we're off to a good start.
Pablo Sandoval stands in as he swings and misses for strike one.
Good job of making him chase that pitch down below the strike zone. That's where you want to pitch when you're looking for the double play ball.
Line drive to center field. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow. And he is back safely at first, and that was almost trouble.
Batting ninth.
Digging in the switch hitter, Blake Swihart. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Now a first pitch changeup here. Too far inside, it's 1-0. Cobb comes set. Here's the 1-0.
Nope.
Fastball that just misses inside.
Well, you wouldn't have expected this kind of at bat out of him, but he's fought himself right back with an opportunity now to really drive in two runs.
Hitters count. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Scooped up on the backhand. He'll flip it to Duffy for the force, and that ends the inning. Red Sox settle for just the one. We played two. There they are, the teammates. Ted Williams, Johnny Pesky, Bobby Doerr, and Dom DiMaggio. Four great Red Sox that played right here as teammates, of course, at Fenway. Tim Beckham is at the plate as he watches ball one. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. A changeup that just catches the bottom of the zone for a strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Smoke toward the hole. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
Now that's a nice base hit right there. Don't overlook this guy just because he's down at the bottom of the order. He's a pretty good hitter.
Stepping in now, Ricky Weeks, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one, and he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
Right there is a temptation pitch. Power hitters like this are looking for pitches that they can drive. So that may have been one where he was trying to get him to chase up above the zone a little bit.
There to look it in his bets, and that's out number one. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Now batting, the center fielder.
Striding in once again, Kevin Kiermaier. 0-for-1 here in the early going. First pitch of the at bat on its way. That slider's almost in the dirt.
Now I'm sure these infielders know it, but this hitter can burn down the baseline. So if he puts a ground ball in play, the defense is going to have to make a perfect turn to turn two.
1-2 is the changeup had him out in front there.
Wow, that changeup is an absolute beaut. They call it the great equalizer for a reason.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Digging in for his second at bat, Matt Duffy. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
1-0.
4-1. Two out with the man at first. Hit on the ground out to short. Gloved by Bogarts. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Rays strand. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. First offering on its way.
Yeehaw.
Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. The windup and the 0-1. Now a swing and a fly ball. And that will end up a foul ball.
He's clearly looking to hit off the fastball and adjust. That's a pretty good swing after seeing two fastballs now in a row.
Drilled to first. Oh, what a stop on the slide. He is out. And that's a huge play to keep the leadoff man off base.
second baseman.
One away, and here's the Dustin 2008 Pedroia. AL MVP, Dustin Pedroia. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. Gone over the monster and out onto Lansdowne Street. A solo home run off the bat of Dustin Pedroia. First home run of the campaign for him. And that gives the Red Sox a 2-0 lead.
Up next for the Red Sox.
In now, Xander Bogaerts.
Xander Bogaerts.
He swings and grounds it to short. Duffy fields it cleanly. On to first, and there were two down.
The batter, right fielder, Mookie.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Mookie Betts. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Dickerson going back, still going back. And it's gone into the monster seats. So a solo shot here to left center field. Home run number 3 here in the early going as the Red Sox have moved out 3-0. Here's the left fielder, Hanley Ramirez.
Hanley.
As he will take a look at strike one on a fastball right down the pipe. 1-for-1 after a single this first time up. Cobb gets the sign, coming at him with the 0-1. Oh, he looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
Oh, wow, that's what they call a jam sandwich. Wow, not much you can do with that pitch that's in tight.
Here's a little chopper up the middle. Barehanded, just late. He's safe. Nearly a remarkable play, but score at a base hit, and the inning continues with two away.
Bradley Jr.
Swing and a line drive, but foul.
Oh, he definitely got away with a changeup right there. He hung that one. But the good news is it got him to pull it foul. Now you come back after him here with another pitch.
Lifted into center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. And that retires the side. Ready for another chance? Evan Longoria. He'll try to get it going here to begin the fourth.
Evan Longoria.
A fastball that finds the outside corner. Bouncer down the line. That winds up foul for the second strike. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Should be no trouble for Bradley, and there's out number one.
Now batting.
Now at the plate, Corey Dickerson. He's 0-for-1 thus far. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Benintendi ranging back. Gone! Over the monster for a home run.
Man, he should have put a bow on that pitch because it was an absolute gift. You could see that he caught too much of the plate and the hitter caught too much of the ball. Sayonara. See you next time.
Wilson. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Betts is over near the line now as he makes the catch for the second out of the inning.
Now batting. Second base.
Digging in to try it again. Brad Miller. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
Still a little bit early to be worrying about this, but in a two-run game, a two-out walk right here could at least get the tying run to the plate. And on top of that, there's some pop on that on-deck circle.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Sandoval ranging into the outfield, but this'll land untouched. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Started to chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. One run on three hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. lifted the other way out to left center. Waiting on it is Benintendi, and that ends the inning. Rays answer right back on the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Red Sox. Now at the plate, Mitch Moreland looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at-bat.
Number 42.
And he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
He's certainly giving up plenty of hits in this one, but the funny thing is he hasn't walked anyone yet. That tells me he's throwing strikes, but he's just not throwing enough quality strikes.
Miller is there. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
Now batting. Third baseman, Pablo.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And standing in now, the versatile Pablo Sandoval. Hit out towards second. Backhanded. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Now batting, catcher Blake Swihart.
And that'll bring in the speedy catcher Blake Swihart. Cobb into the windup. First pitch on the way. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Souza going back on it. He makes the play. A great catch on the run to retire the side. Takes just four pitches to retire the Red Sox as the lead remains 3-1. Settling in now, Stephen Souza. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Lifted in the air out to center field. Bradley is there. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting, the first baseman.
Into the box now, Tim Beckham. A base hit in his first trip. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing and one.
Well, they're still in this game. You know, if they can get somebody on, a broken bat, a blooper, a bunt, and then go for the big ball, they can get something going. But they got to start with getting somebody on base. This offense needs a base runner and get things happening.
On to Moreland, and that's in time for the second out.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Ricky Weeks.
Striding into the box, Ricky Weeks comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. And a swing and a miss, so Weeks is in a hole here, no balls and two strikes.
He has been aggressive in this inning. 0-2 on this hitter. The first two outs were recorded quick because he came right after the hitter. I don't think that changes right now either. He's going to continue to be aggressive to this hitter as well.
Chopped weakly to the left. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Last half of the fifth coming up. Stepping in, Andrew Benintendi. He'll lead things off as we begin the home fifth.
Andrew Benintendi.
First pitch coming. Here it is. To right field and way out of here. Look at this thing go. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed.
Well, when you groove the first pitch a strike, these hitters are going to make you pay. Something tells me I don't have to tell the guy on the mound that anymore. That hurts.
Now batting.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. He's off to a fast start in this one. 2-for-2, including a home run. Into the windup and the pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that'll get down for a base hit. He's around first, heading for two. And he is in the second base with a double. His third hit this afternoon. Now the Rays manager's going to take that slow walk out toward the mound. And he has signaled to the bullpen. That's going to be all for his starter, Alex Cobb. Nate Eovaldi is going to take over here in inning number 5. So it'll be a bullpen game from here on out. Sends that one out of play for strike one.
That's a big fastball, obviously, and we're going to see this reliever throw it a lot.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Hit on the ground to third. Throw on to first by Longoria is right there for the first out.
Now batting.
Digging in and looking for more, Mookie Betts. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip. First pitch of the at bat. Sharp slider that time, just missed inside. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Fastball down near the shoe tops.
Runner on third base finds himself down 2-0. Look, there's no reason to give him anything good. If you walk him, sets up the double play.
2-0 count and the pitch. Oh, and he turns another one around here. And his fine ball game will continue. Give him another home run.
Well, as a team, they've gone yard four times. And this guy's accounted for half of them. Memo to all pitchers the rest of the game. If this guy comes to the plate, you might want to pitch around him.
Here's the left fielder, Hanley Ramirez. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Here comes the 0-1. Got a big pass at a slider that gets past him. And action now in the Tampa Bay pen as it looks like a right-hander's begun to get loose. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Ramos gathers it, and the throw to first is there to record the second out.
Now batting.
Here's Jackie Bradley now. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. Squared that one up just a little late. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone-cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
Well, that base hit right there extends the streak to 10 games. When you start getting hits over 10 games, you've been pretty consistent over the last two series you've been playing. Really good ball right now.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Pitch misses low. The throw down. It's up the ladder, and the tag comes in too late, so he's in at second base here with two away.
Clearly, they're not satisfied with the lead they're working with right now, and I like that. You don't want to disrespect your opponent and do that in a blowout game, but I don't think you can get comfortable with a five-run lead, and now they've got a chance to add on.
Swinging a hard liner to center field. Kiermaier is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Red Sox on top, six. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. And Dan, he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
No, your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action. And they just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
And that's in there for strike one. The windup and the 0-1. Dribbled to the right side. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Now batting, shortstop, Matt Duffy.
Digging in once again, Matt Duffy, 0 for 2 on the afternoon so far. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. The pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. One run on three hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And a neck-high fastball that time. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Grounder down the line at third. And this is right by Sandoval down the line, a fair ball.
Well, that's the sixth game he's hit in. He's swinging the bat pretty good now. That's a six-game streak. You got to start somewhere. Longoria. Pay attention, people. He's getting hot.
Evan Longoria is in for the third time as he swings and misses at that one. It's nothing and one.
That's the exact pitch he wants him to swing at, that ball down in the zone. Double play situation. That's where you get that double play.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Benintendi racing back.
Everyone in the stadium, including the guy in the mound, who it was just a matter of time until this guy cranked him out of here. Well, that's the first one of the year, and many more are sure to follow.
Corey Dickerson comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And Pedroia will stretch, but it's into center field for a base hit.
Now that's a swing you want to put in your memory bank. He got off to a slow start here in April, but that's something to build on. And if he can continue to move forward, we'll see him get the average up soon.
Wilson Ramos is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. Here's the 0-1. And he misses with it 1-1.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
Well, now it's a 1-2 count. He's throwing the same pitch three times in a row. He got ahead with it. Now let's see if he puts him away with it.
Runners on first with one down. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Dickerson rounds the corner and is headed home. Not in time, and he's in there with a double. And the runner from first comes around to score. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance, and he doesn't try to do too much.
Tyler Thornburg will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far. Standing in now, Brad Miller, as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. The 0-1 on its way. Way in front of that fastball. Three runs already home here. Now a swing and a miss, maybe even a foul tip, but it's held onto behind the plate for out number two. Ready for another chance? Steven Souza. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. In there, and it's 0-1. Grounded softly to the right. Up with the ball is Pedroia. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Here's the Panda now, Pablo Sandoval. 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon.
Pablo Sandoval.
And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Now the pitch. This one smoked the other way, high and deep to left. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Smoked on the ground, left side. And just past his outstretched glove into left, the base hit.
Well, balls are flying all over the ballpark in this one here, right here, man. Leadoff single, another one here in the middle innings to get things going. This has been a great offensive performance by both teams.
Into the box, Blake Swihart. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Hard hit ball to second. And that is just past his outstretched glove, and that ought to be a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Well, I like that approach right there. Hard ground ball to right field. And in terms of the play, you see the guy holding the runner at first and the second baseman with double play depth. You create a hole right there, and you try to shoot the ball right through it. Great execution.
Oh, look at the dive. What a play.
He beat it out.
Hey, great job of hustle there by the base runner. That looked like an easy inning-ending double play. Now runners at first and third with two outs.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. And he's got a shot at history here, but he'll need a triple to complete the cycle. First offering on its way. Line towards center field. Kiermaier is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. Now the relay home is in time, and he's cut down at the plate as they team up to gun him down. Red Sox leave one. They're up 6-4. Digging in to try it again, Tim Beckham. He's one for two in the ballgame.
Tim Beckham.
And here's a fastball called for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Bradley is there. He's got it one away.
Now batting, designated hitter.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Ricky Weeks. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. Here's the pitch. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Hit hard on the ground to second. On to first, as that'll take care of Weeks for out number two.
Up next for Tampa Bay, center
standing
fielder.
In, Kevin Kiermaier. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And he lays off for ball one. Two out, nobody on. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike.
Probably better that he let that pitch go anyway. After seeing a lively fastball on the pitch before, it's pretty hard to sit back enough on a well-thrown changeup.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. The 2-2 one more time. Third ball locks him up, strike three, and that's the third out. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They trail it here, 6-4. Striding in once again, Xander Bogaerts. They'll try and get something started in the home half of the seventh.
Xander Bogaerts.
Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left. A swing and a miss at the good old Uncle Charlie.
I really like how the catcher and the pitcher are reading swings. The pitch before, big power swing. Then they pull the string on him and get him out in front early. He has no idea what's coming now.
Boy, it's hard to sit on an 0-2 fastball. I think that pitch just locked him up a bit. But lucky for him, it was just a little out of the zone.
Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first. And I thought this might happen based on how close that play was at first. The skipper's out of the dugout, and it looks as though he might decide to challenge that out call.
Yeah, he may, Matt, but I think he'll see what his replay guys think first. Looking at it again, man, I can't tell for sure if he was out or not. Tough call.
So here's the signal from the bench, and they will indeed ask for the play to be reviewed. So the umpires will get on the horn with the replay operations center in Manhattan and attempt to get a definitive answer on this play. And boy, well hit, but out of play into the stands in deep right. The windup and the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. Ready once again, Hanley Ramirez. He's 2-for-3 thus far. Into the windup and the pitch. Here's a first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. Here's the 1-0 now to Ramirez. Skied into straightaway right. Souza's after it. Legs churning. He's headed for second. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with two away on a ground rule double.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
Here's Jackie Bradley now. And this is sliced hard down the left field line. And this is a fair ball as it makes its way out toward the monster. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second. That makes it 7-4.
Now batting.
Stepping up now, Mitch Moreland. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone. For Bradley, it's his fourth double here in this early part of the year. 0-1, here's the pitch. The knee buckler, and he swings and misses at it.
Well, he's got him thinking right now. There's a fastball, then it comes back at the curveball and gets him out in front. I think when you get him out in front like that, you come back and throw another curveball right here.
There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Souza racing back. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. It's Jackie Bradley Jr. who hits the jackpot. Digging in and looking for more, Matt Duffy. And to start out the inning, it looks like they've decided to stick with the same reliever out there, Dan.
They have, Matt. I think the way he pitched the last inning kind of inspired that. But it's not uncommon for relief pitchers to have troubles after they sit and watch their guys swing the bat a bit. We'll see if he stays as sharp as he was before.
A little bouncer, foul ball, strike two. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. A ball and two strikes, here's the pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight.
How about it?
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Now batting.
Ready for another shot now, Corey Dickerson. And they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
Swing and a miss, and he's in the hole 0-2 now.
Watching him on the mound, I'm really impressed with what he's doing right now. He's been really aggressive and confident over the last couple of innings.
Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Coming to the plate now,
leading
Pablo Sandoval. He'll see what he can do leading off the home eight. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Kiermaier ranging back, and it bangs off the monster. And that's in there, base hit. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
He obviously didn't let last night's hitless outing get to his head too much, because that's his second hit of the ball game. This one a double. I'm sure he's feeling a lot better about the way he's going right now.
And that'll bring in the speedy catcher, Blake Swihart. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one. Well, for Sandoval, that gives him five doubles now on the year. Line drive to center field. Kiermaier is there, and he has it for the first out. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
Now batting.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. He's homered and doubled in four trips, so he's definitely been a factor. First offering on its way. Couldn't wait back, a swing and a miss. One out and a runner on second base. Awfully close with the slider there, but it's one and one.
Clearly staying away from him in this at bat with that runner in scoring position tells me they're trying to force him to reach for something and maybe roll over on
it. Here's the one and one pitch. Way out in front. Has a look, now the pitch. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
And that ball's not intentional. That was not even a fastball. Relax, relax now, people. I know we get excited when the ball's up and in.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss on the breaking pitch. Two away.
Yeah, third strikeout of the game for him, and this one he was way off balance and out in front of that curveball. He's had no answer for the pitching he's faced in this one, and I'm not sure he's too happy with himself right now.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. This gets foul. It's 0-1. The 0-1. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play.
Oh, man, I think he thought he was going to get another breaking ball right there. He's a little bit late on that fastball. That's a nice pitch, though, falling that breaking pitch to keep him off balance with the heater.
To his left, Duffy. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Striding in, Wilson Ramos. He'll try and lead things off here in inning number nine.
Wilson.
Into the windup and the pitch. Here we go with inning number nine. Joe Kelly will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Shoots this one over to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself. One gone here in the ninth.
Now batting, second baseman. Brad Miller.
Now at the plate, Brad Miller. Lifetime versus Joe Kelly. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. Now time is called, and this might be to buy a little time for that reliever to get loose. Craig Kimbrell answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. Right on the corner, a fastball that he takes for a strike. Here's the 0-1. And this is going to be a foul ball.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
Well, it's been a rough series for him at the plate so far. That's four strikeouts in the first two games, so this pitching staff clearly has him figured out.
Steven Souza is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Well, as demonstrated there, that's a tough pitch to do anything with.
Yeah, good luck. Hey,
and he holds up on this one, but it's a called strike three. And with that, the ball game is over.
Hey, a great win for these guys as they wrap up another one. But a little bit of a sour note, though. Everyone has to head home, get on those computers, and get those taxes out before midnight.
7-4 the final finish today. The Boston Red Sox with a big 17-hit attack. Eduardo Rodriguez claims the win out of the pen.